Question number 7, the Honourable To Henare.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. My question is to the Minister of Transport. How is Linda Lovelace these days?
Order. 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 The House had better come to order, please.
Mr. Speaker.
The Honourable To
Henare. My question is... Just give everybody 5 minutes and we'll be back into it. Mr. Speaker, my question is to the Minister of Transport. What progress has been made on the Victoria Park Tunnel Road of national significance?
Your point of order, the old Trevor Ballard.
Yeah, I think there's an amount of giggling here. We didn't all hear To Henare's interjection. I wonder whether you'd like to repeat it.
I'm sure that's not in The Honourable Stephen Joyce.
Mr. Speaker, good news. I visited the Victoria Park construction site this morning. And I'm pleased to report to the House that Aucklanders will begin benefiting from the Victoria Park tunnel in November this year. Well ahead of schedule, the $340 million Victoria Park Tunnel project will increase the capacity of State Highway 1 between the Auckland Harbour Bridge and Newmarket, one of the country's most important freight and commercial routes and the last major bottleneck of the Central Motorway Junction. It's great to see the whole program will be completed in February, 3 months earlier than planned.
The Honourable To Henare.
How has the government's commitment to infrastructure spending boosted confidence in the construction sector?
The Honourable Stephen Joyce.
Mr. Speaker, the government's funding pipeline of $10.7 billion of state highway funding over 10 years has provided a secure funding pipeline which has given contractors the confidence to continue investing in their people and machinery and completing projects more quickly. This has sped up the construction of a project that may in fact never have happened if the previous government had cut back on their state highway funding as they had planned. I'm pleased that this confidence is flowing through to a number of projects that are now being delivered even earlier than scheduled. Last week I announced the Hobsonville motorway would be complete 6 months ahead of schedule. Last year the southbound part of the Newmarket Viaduct opened early and the Manukau Harbour Crossing also opened early.